नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, kotaris, tanidas, participants, visible and invisible beings. Siddhas, rishis, ganas, किन्नर किंबुर गंधर्व गंधार यक्ष रक्षस एवरी वन हु इज हियर फॉर दिस सत्संग सिटिंग विथ अस थ्रू नित्यानंद टीवी साधना टीवी लोटस टीवी two-way video conferencing all over the world, from all over the world here and all over the world in their places. Blessings from Anandavana, Ananda Ganda Madhye, महादेव नित्यं अद्वितीयं इष्टदैवतं निरंजनं हु इज एटर्नली इन द स्पेस ऑफ नॉन ड्युअलिटी एंड हु इज द चोसन डेटी इष्टदैव लव्ड बाय एवरीवन एंड लव्स एवरीवन Niranjana, embodiment of beyond purity and impurity. Nice to be here in the Anandavana and nice to have all of you in Anandavana. This place is originally called as Anandavana. As Mahadeva settled here, this is the first city Mahadeva created for himself and for his ganas. The city is older than legends itself. City is older than history itself. If you go to that original Varanasi, the place is called Avimukta Kshetra, never forsaken. Even during the Pralaya, Mahadeva holds this city in the tip of his Trishul. By raising his Trishul, he holds this city. That is why this city is called Urdhvamnaya. It is neither Dakshinamnaya, Uttaramnaya, Paschimamnaya. It is called Urdhvamnaya. Shankara describes this city. Shankara divides the world as four parts. Southern part, northern part, eastern part and western part. But he tells Kashi is neither southern nor eastern or western or northern. He tells Kashi as Urdhvamnaya, upward direction. The city held by Mahadeva in the tip of his Trishul. I want all of you to know, I am not talking some stories or some old beliefs. Whatever I am uttering, I am responsible for it. So please understand, with all my integrity I am saying, this city is older than history itself, older than legends itself, and this place is really Urdhvamnaya, never forsaken, Avimukta Kshetra. Mahadeva settled here when he was carrying the human body. First, this is the first city Mahadeva created, and this is where he started teaching the great science of enlightenment to the world. All the aspects of enlightenment, yoga, hatha yoga, siddha yoga, tantra, agora, natha, all the great sampradayas, the traditions of enlightenment started overflowing from him in this very Anandavana. Originally the place was named as Anandavana by Mahadeva. Even now, in all the sankalpa, puja mantras, Mahadeva is addressed in this place. The place is addressed as Anandavana. Please listen. Later on, when Ganga came here to have darshan of Mahadeva, two streams, Varuna and Asi, joined in Ganga. The place between the two streams was renamed as Varanasi, but originally the name given by Mahadeva is Anandavana. Every city has a spiritual name, every deity has a spiritual name in our tradition. In Tiruvannamalai, the city is named as Arunachala, and the deity is Arunagiri Yogishwara. Officially, the deity is called Arunagiri Yogishwara. So, when the pujas are performed, the name Arunagiri Yogishwara only is used. Same way, in Madurai, the city's spiritual name is Madhurapuri Kshetra, and the deity is called Sundaresa Mahadeva. Each city has a spiritual name and the deity has a spiritual name. Here, the city's spiritual name is Anandavana, deity is called Nityananda. If you go to Vishwanatha temple and listen to the Sankalpa mantra, you will see the pandits chanting Anandavani Anandagandamadye Nityanandaya Itam Namama. They will be chanting in the Anandavana, the center of the Anandaganda, Nityananda is offered all this. Itam Namama means I don't exist. Mahadeva is addressed here as Nityananda. The place is addressed as Anandavana. This is the first Sarvanya Pita Mahadeva established. Means the seat of learning which Mahadeva himself established. From Mahadeva, all the rishis learnt then starts the tradition of Narayana. Narayana was initiated here in the form of Kapila. Kapila Maharshi, incarnation, fifth incarnation of Narayana, Vishnu, lived here, became enlightened here, and left the body here. His samadhi is still in Varanasi, where he lived and left the physical body he carried. From Narayana, Bhatma Bhava, Vasishta, Shakti, Parasara, Vyasa, Suga, Gaudapata, Govindapata, Shankara Bhagavatpata, the Sampradaya continues. I'm so happy for all of you. You are all here. The spiritual capital of the world. To learn the science of enlightenment. If I have to put it more precisely, to experience the science of enlightenment from the source. Be rest assured, I am responsible for the last word. Be rest assured, with all my integrity and authenticity, I am giving you the word. You are learning from the original source. You are learning, you are experiencing from the original source in its pristine purity. Be rest assured about that. Be assured about that. I welcome all of you to this Anandavana, to learn from the source, experience the source, the great science of enlightenment, science of life. This is the place where life started. This is the place where science of living started. This is the place where science of enlightenment is shared first time on the planet Earth. I just welcome you all. And in one word, if I have to say, I am so happy for all of you. Happy to be here, happy to have you all with me here. Get ready for a spiritual blast. As I said, this city is, if you understand, the most fascinating. Please understand, this city is literally cosmos. If you understand, you will find such a great order in the chaos. If you don't, you will find chaos, so much of chaos in everything. The person who understands, for them, this city is most fascinating. If you don't understand, this will be most frustrating. Just like life. just like life. If you understand, most fascinating, if not most frustrating. Varanasi, Anandavana, is just mirror Mahadeva shows to you. When you see the mirror, you can be frustrated. You can plan for your threading and makeup, or you can do completion. It's all up to you. Varanasi is the mirror Mahadeva shows to you. If you understand, this is the most fascinating city, if not most frustrating city. Here, bulls, dogs, beggars, sadhus, great paramahamsas, dead bodies, snakes, all of us walk together in small lanes, crisscrossing each other again and again with shoulder to shoulder. All of us have to live together. You can't avoid anyone. And the beauty is, no one hurts each other. Everyone is happy to be in other space. I tell you, I never had even one thought, this city is dirty or too congested. Never ever had one thought. If you go to that original Anandavana, there is no street which is more than 3 feet. Please understand. 3 feet width. Actually, I was contemplating why. I read some of the history books, they are saying the city was planned and built before even the bullock cart was discovered. But I was not ready to believe that. I consciously scanned the Akashic records. I tell you, Kala Bhairava revealed very clearly, now whatever we are using as a road is just drainage. The city was created for the people who had naturally the ability of flying. So we never bothered to create roads. That was the response from Kala Bhairava. We never had roads because we never had people who were walking. Originally, when the city was formed, it was not planned for the people who were walking on the ground. It was planned for the rishis, Gandharvas, Kinnara, Kimburuda, Gana, Ganadhyas, who were naturally flying, who had the power of levitation and flying. They were living here, so we never had the need for road. The buildings are just the place where they assumed the human body and taught this science or learnt this science. Learnt from the masters, taught to disciples. So this was the oldest city, oldest university, oldest hospital, and oldest monastery and what not. On behalf of ஆல் த ரிஷி முனி கண கிண்ணர கிம்புருட கந்தர்வ காந்தார தேவ சித்த வித்யாதர லைஃப் ஆஃப் காஷி அண்ட் ஆன் பிஹாஃப் ஆஃப் த வெரி சோர்ஸ் இட் செல்ஃப் ஐ வெல்கம் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ டு திஸ் சேக்ரட் சிட்டி. And you need to know, they are all very happy celebrating your presence. They are all really, really, really happy to have all of us here. This is the place where all the spiritual freaks gather from time immemorial. Understand? The word Paramahamsa, I am translating as spiritual freaks. You may think the word looks too low, but I tried, I could not find any other word in English. So I am okay with that word. From time immemorial, sadhus, nahas, siddhas, paramahamsas gather to celebrate life and celebrate death. Here, life is liberation, death is celebration. Life is liberation, death is celebration. This city is built out of all our sacred sentiments. That is why every king of Bharat, from Gandhara, Afghanistan, to Bali, Indonesia, every king has their palace here. Whether Nepal king or Bhutan, Burma, of course, Burma doesn't have a king now, when they had. Nepal also doesn't have a king now, when they had. From Gandhara to Bali, all the kings have their palace here. All the great Jagatgurus, Pitadishwas, masters have their ashram or monastery here. This whole city is built not just with mud, stone, wood, mortar. It is built with our sacred sentiments. That is why Ramakrishna says this city is golden city, because all our sacred sentiments are filled and this city is built. If I have to introduce this place, I have to introduce the whole Hinduism, Sanatana Hindu Dharma. I have to introduce the whole science of enlightenment, which I will be doing for next 21 days. Today, we have some more auspicious things. First, we are inaugurating 26th Inner Awakening, 23rd Ingenious, and the Nirahara Samyama, the Samyama batch. I And today is also Ashramites Day. The first Ashramite, Ma Sadananda and Sri Nitya Sadananda, came to stay with me in the ashram, in the Erode. The way the Sangha was formed from Adi Nityananda Dhyana Peetam Avattipalayam. So, we celebrate today as the Ashramites Day, honoring all the beings who dedicated their life to be part of the Sangha as sannyasi, Sri Mahant, Mahant, Kotari, Tanedar, Rishi, Balasans, Krama Brahmacharis, Brahmacharinis, Maswamis, Goswamis, and Sri Swamis, in every form, or as ashramite, or volunteer, whatever way, whatever name, whatever title, all the beings who have dedicated become ashramites, part of the Sangha, today is dedicated to them. With my being, I bless all of you. It is because of you I am here, and I know you are all here for me. I congratulate and thank all the ashramites, whether you are a balasant or full-time volunteer or ashramite, staying in our campuses, where you are part, be very clear, you are a part. And I thank, congratulate, accept, respect, honor you being part of my Sangha, you being part of our Sangha. I know you are here for me. I want you to know I am here for you. It is ashramites who kept the Sangha alive. I sincerely honor the commitment of my ashramites, and I know you are all here for me. I take this moment green chilli, maybe little spicy, but very good for digestion. Chilli may be little spicy, very good for digestion. Sometimes the words from my tongue may be little spicy, but very good for digestion. Now, I take this moment to tell you guys, I am here for all of you, and you are all parts of me. You are all my being. I am part of you. You, me, you is the only way we can define who we are for each other. If I have to define who you are for me, or if I have to define who I am for you, the only way I can describe this relationship is you, me, you. That's all. And Second, I also inaugurate today the new Singapore Center and Temple.
The devotees of Singapore are now coming on the stage to offer the garland to Swamiji on the auspicious day of the inauguration of the new Singapore Center.
Blessings. Singapore is always one beautiful feather on my cap. My blessings to the Singapore Center. I accept the aarti and the puja. So through this, formally, I inaugurate the Singapore new ashram and temple and center. I also bless the nominated member of parliament, Sri Srinivas Rai, gracing the occasion. Thank you for being here. I am happy to have you here in our center. And my blessings to all of you. It's so nice to have all of you. And by this formal inauguration, I am throwing open the Singapuram Nityananda Vedic Temple, Ashram, Center to the people of Singapore. My blessings. As my gift to Singapore, I'll be sending all the deities, Nityanandeshwara, Nityanandeshwari, Nityananda, and this turban which I am wearing today. As a gift to the Singapore Ashram. Blessings. And I also accept what you gave. And can you all guys say just hi to Singapore Ashram? The devotees are gathered. Can you all wave for Singapore devotees? Yes, your counterpart. And I also want to take this moment to thank our Mahans, Sri Mahans, Kotaris, Thanedars, devotees, disciples, everyone, for holding the Singapore Sangha together and making this new temple happen. Blessings. Thank you. Thank you, Singapore devotees. Thank you, Singapore Sangha. The Singapore Sangha, so courageous, they stood and literally they revived themselves just like Nityananda. Stood true to the Nityananda Sampradaya and Nityananda Sangha, Nityananda tradition. Thank you guys for this beautiful ashram, come temple, come center and everything. Thank you. Blessings. And the deities are ready. You can ship it any moment you want. Any moment you want, you can take it. And the turban, you can take it today after the satsang. And as the part of the ashramites day, few of our ashramites are offering. Some of the ashramites in Singapore are offering the garlands. I accepted the garland and puja, everything, blessings. I sincerely thank all of you. My blessings. And last but not least, very important. Today the Meenakshi Brahmotsavam starts. So now by offering aarti to Meenakshi and Sundareshwara, Nityanandeshwara, Nityanandeshwari and Nityananda, the deities. Today 10:36 to 11 a.m. in our Bidhi Ashram, the formal Dvajaroganam. In Bidhi Ashram and San Jose, Madurai, formal Dvajaroganam will be happening and the Brahmotsavam will start. Now by offering this aarti, officially I inaugurate Meenakshi's Chitre Brahmotsavam. Sarthi, formally I inaugurate Meenakshi's Chitre Brahmotsavam celebrations all over the world in all our ashrams, centers and temples. Now the traditional rituals can start in Bidhi, San Jose, in all our Devi temples. So we will be celebrating the Meenakshi Brahmotsavam here in Varanasi. That is why the deities are here. We will have the celebrations continuously for next 15 days. It is a 15-day Brahmotsavam. So we will be celebrating from today, just like Madurai, 12 days for Mahadeva, 3 days for Vishnu. I also would like to inaugurate and release the book. This is the offering from publication department as a mark of Ashramites Day, Essence of Living Enlightenment in Spanish. Thank you, publication department. Thank you for this offering to the world, the flip book of Essence of Living Enlightenment in Spanish. Thank you. My blessings. Whoever reads this, let them experience living enlightenment. My blessings. So, thank you all for being here. Today's essence of today's satsang. Thank you all for being here. Thank you all the ashramites on this auspicious Ashramites Day. Understand? The best revenge is rebuild. I don't have time to hate the people who hate me because I am too busy in loving the people who love me. I don't have time to hate the people who hate me because I am too busy in loving the people who love me. The best revenge is rebuild. We did it. Oh my dear Ashramites, we did it. And thank you, Singapore Sangha, sentimentally inaugurating your new ashram, new campus today. My blessings. Get ready for a spiritual blast. I know the spiritual blast has started yesterday itself with a formal Kashi Yatra. Yesterday itself we had a formal Kashi Yatra. Of course, people who did not participate yesterday, don't feel you missed out something. No, you have not missed out. We are going to have again a formal Kashi Yatra. Here Kashi itself is worshipped as Kashiya Devi. Like how in Thiruvannamalai, the Arunachala, the hill itself is worshipped as Mahadeva. In Kailash, the Manasarovar itself is worshipped as Devi. Here, the city itself is worshipped as a goddess, Kashiya Devi. So first you are supposed to have the darshan of Kashiya Devi. Means from Varuna to Asi, you have to go by boat, by bowing down to Kashiya Devi, as per the tradition. Only then you can enter Kashi. So yesterday, we followed the tradition. Even if you are too big Advaiti, please bear with me. I'll be following lot of all these traditions. Now sometime in the internet I get lot of messages. Now when I listen to your discourses, I think you are a great enlightened being. But when I see your behavior, you are bowing down to stones, you are bowing down to trees, you worship the street side temples. I feel you may be still stuck somewhere. I don't know what you wanted to think or decide. But I am very clear. I am going to worship every tree, every stone, again and again and again. And I am going to create more and more stones and trees for worship purpose. I will revive Sanatana Hindu Dharma in all its juicy, colorful ways. So, the whole program, not only it will be transmitting Advaitic experience to you, it will be transmitting and giving you the experience of the great culture of Sanatana Dharma through various traditional activities. Like yesterday I said, yesterday we did the Kashi Yatra, darshan of Kashiya Devi. And we may also do lot of temple visits, the at least major temple visits, pujas, homas, everything. Devi Mahatmya, Devi says, ekai vaham jagat yatra dvitiya ka mamapara. It's a quotation from our Vyakarana Shiromani Sri Ambananda Swami. Who else is existing me other than me? Devi herself is the embodiment of Advaita. So bowing down to gods is bowing down to Advaita. We will be having lot of temples, rituals, pujas, kirtans, without missing the intensity of the inner awakening. You will have both in a right combination, like Varanasi bong. Don't mistake, bong means it is not intoxicant. Actually, the original bong is not intoxicant. later on they started diluting it or adding many more things. The original bhang is actually Ayurvedic liver cleanser. It doesn't intoxicate you, but it just gives you the joy and excitement. It never does the damage alcohol does to your system. So bhang is the traditional Ayurvedic drink. It gives you excitement but not intoxication. There is a big difference. It doesn't damage your liver or body. It only cleanses your body of all toxins. From Kashi Bhang to Pan. Kashi Pan is also unique. Kashi Bhang to Pan. Pujas, rituals, get ready to have a spiritual blast. And I will sincerely request and recommend all of you, if you drop your resistance for deities and the culture of Sanatana Hindu Dharma, please understand, just like a New York represents a way of life. Now, I am not here to judge whether it is right or wrong. New York represents a way of life. Same way, this city represents our way of life. This represents Sanatana Hindu Dharma. So, it will be nice. The earlier you drop the resistance, earlier you will start enjoying. This city will become fascinating for you. Whether you are from Western countries, or you are an NRI or RNI. RNI means residential non-Indians. NRI is a non-residential Indian. RNI is a residential non-Indian. Whether you are from other countries or NRI or RNI, if you drop the resistance for the Sanatana Hindu Dharma way of life, you will really, really, really enjoy. Because whether you want it or not, you are in a program locked with a man for next 21 days whose passion is this Sanatana Hindu Dharma. The quicker you drop the resistance, the more you will enjoy. The more you will enjoy, I welcome all of you to enjoy, celebrate. I am not saying you accept whatever Kashi represents, Varanasi represents. I am only saying don't resist, don't accept. Don't resist, don't accept. Just see what it can do to you, that's all. I am not saying accept, I am not saying resist. If you already accepted and waiting to enjoy, great, come on, join the club. Otherwise, don't resist, don't accept, just see what it can do to you. I tell you, it will do to you what it did to me. Bhang may not be intoxicating, Pan may not be intoxicating, but Banaras itself is intoxicating. Understand, Banarasi Bhang may not be intoxicating, Banarasi Pan may not be intoxicating, but Banaras is intoxicating. I can tell you that much. It is such a fascinating city. That's the right word I'll use. Such fascinating city. I lived and slept, died in this city, understand. I lived in this city, ate, slept, died in this city. But everything in this city, including death, was fascinating. I can go through anything in this city. It's worth going through. I tell you, I can go through anything in this city, including death. It is worth going through. Thank you guys for being here to share this joy with me. It's because of all of you I am here. So, thank you, thank you, thank you for being here to share, celebrate the Varanasi. You may be here, whatever reason, whether for your physical healing, mental healing, or to have the enlightenment, or to learn the science of accumulating more wealth, or to complete with your relationships, to heal your relationships, revive your life energy, awaken your kundalini, whatever may be the purpose you are here. Said, unsaid, with my integrity, authenticity, responsibility, and enriching, I give you the word, please listen, I give you the word, my commitment, keeping Kala Bhairava as witness, I'll be your co-creator and cause the reality you wanted to create. Cause the reality you wanted to create. I commit with you. I'll do everything, everything needed. It's my commitment. I know I'll fulfill it. Few minutes, I'll lead you all into Kalpataru process. All the non-IA participants can have Kalpataru darshan, because all the IA participants, all of you are going to have the energy darshan. So, these few minutes in the morning, we will give it to Kashi Vashis who come here for Kalpataru Darshan, the devotees from Varanasi who have come for Kalpataru Darshan. So, all the participants who are here for Kalpataru and IA, let's enter into Kalpataru. I bless you all, let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.